Dr. Hatch Salmon, a man of considerable girth and advancing years, perched precariously on a barstool in the airport lounge. A whiskey in hand, his disgruntled mutterings echoed in the hushed ambience. His words, a jumbled concoction of slurred protest, were about his sovereign right to enjoy his drink in silence. The air grew thicker with discomfort as his belligerence escalated. "It's a free country, isn't it?" he declared, his voice ricocheting off the walls. The other passengers exchanged glances, their eyes wide with unease, but no one dared to intervene. They had heard the tales of Dr. Salmon's notorious temper. As his flight was announced, he staggered to his feet, his spectacle far from over. His journey to the gate was punctuated by a cacophony of slurred words and the clink of his glass. As the plane ascends, a peculiar sensation overcomes Dr. Salmon. He looks around, a fog of confusion clouding his eyes. This isn't his flight. This isn't the route to New York. Dr. Salmon awakens to the startling realization that he is not, in fact, on a plane to New York. He's en route to Tokyo, Japan. There's a palpable sense of confusion in the air as our dear doctor, still foggy from his whiskey-infused slumber, struggles to make sense of his surroundings. His outbursts, like a tempest in a teacup, create ripples of bewilderment among the fellow passengers. "This isn't my flight. I'm supposed to be in New York," he bellows, his voice echoing through the cabin. But his protests are met with nothing more than perplexed glances and stifled giggles as the passengers watch the spectacle unfold. Eventually, the whiskey pulls him back into slumber's grasp, his snores just another layer of in-flight entertainment. When he awakens again, the neon lights of Tokyo greet him, a stark contrast to the concrete jungle he was expecting. Stumbling out of the airport, disoriented and bewildered, Dr. Salmon takes his first steps into the vibrant chaos of Tokyo. Our bewildered scientist, now wandering the streets of Tokyo, is a sight that draws both shock and amusement. His eyes dart around wildly, a mix of confusion and frustration etched on his face. It's a spectacle that could easily be mistaken for a scene from a slapstick comedy if it wasn't so painfully real. Dr. Salmon, in all his disoriented glory, is clearly not just another tourist lost in translation. No, he's a man who's found himself in a situation that's far beyond a simple navigational mishap. And the people of Tokyo, they see this. They see past his belligerence, past his drunken ramblings. They see a man in need, and so they step in. They offer him a warm bowl of ramen, a comforting cup of sake, a friendly hand to guide him through the labyrinthine streets. In his hour of need, these strangers become his lifeline, his beacon in the chaos. In the midst of the bustling city of Tokyo, Dr. Hatch Salmon, lost and far from home, finds himself on the receiving end of unexpected kindness.